Larissa, I mean, we are having two perspectives on the visitorship of that exhibition. So our papers are actually quite close to each other. So thank you for introducing me. Thank you for inviting me. I'm really glad to discuss this exhibition in the context of this conference again. The exhibition German Colonialism, Fragments Past and Present, closed its doors in May of this year. It was initiated and shown by the Deutsches Historisches Museum in Berlin, a historical museum, actually the National Museum. I developed the concept and curated this exhibition together with a project team of historians and art historians. In this talk, I'd like to turn to the only object in the exhibition that I, as the curator, did not know before, the visitor book, for two reasons. As a temporarily recruited curator, it is difficult to give answers to many of the questions raised in the context of this conference. So I can't say if that special exhibition, for example, changed the institution. And secondly, I was struck by the abundance of strong reactions that had gathered in the visitor book. And I'm looking forward to exchange experiences here as well with other colleagues. For this reason, I'll tackle the visitor book as a site where the contested memory of German colonialism is performed. My close reading is not an evaluation of the exhibition, and it's less concerned with the impact of curatorial strategies than with intersections with public discourses. Nevertheless, a short introduction to the institutional background and the concept of the exhibition is required to approach the visitor book. The Deutsches Historisches Museum is one of the few museums in Germany that is administered by the state and not by a federal state or a municipality. As a national museum, it is an institutional agent of official historical culture and memory politics. The museum is prominently positioned on Unter den Linden in Berlin, in the vicinity of the construction site of the constantly debated Humboldt Forum and the Foreign Office that acknowledged the German genocide on the Herero Nama in July 2015. German colonialism, Fragments Past and Present, was shown as a major special exhibition on about 1,000 square meters. It gathered objects from a wide range of collections, among them ethnological museums, but also mission archives, estates, federal archives of the colonial administration, a linguistic audio archive, and so on. Over its runtime of 7 months, around 135,000 visitors saw the exhibition, which is a lot even for that museum. And since then, at least no one can say anymore that colonialism isn't interesting to people in Germany. The exhibition advocated a critical understanding of colonialism, which addressed violence and racist ideology, and at once referred to the complexity of colonial encounters in a microhistorical approach, to put across that the notion of the colonial is employed for a variety of experiences. And here, the introductory text panel, the second paragraph, gives you an idea how we framed colonialism in this exhibition. The colonial archive enabled and determined that exhibition, and my curatorial work became very much a working through this archive, understood as the body of collections and archives that document, support, and legitimize the colonial project, and all the questions it gives rise to. And we decided to raise these questions as well in the introductory text, which is the final paragraph. The exhibition didn't leave the borders of this archive. Rather, a reflexive approach to the material relics is put to practice in readings with and against the grain, a way of dealing with entanglements of collections and colonial relations, and the discrepancy between the immense collections and archives and the voices and counter-voices that are effective in it. The deprivation of the colonies after World War I, and thus the absence of a process of decolonization, differentiates German colonial history from that of other European powers. And a migration from the colonies, which in other European nations contributed decisively to contested colonial memory, remained marginal. Discussion in Germany continues to run the risk of equating colonialism with the formal possession of colonies and to point to the comparatively short duration and dimension of German colonialism. Furthermore, national memory in Germany is marked by the World Wars, the division of Germany, and particularly the experience of the Holocaust. Thus, the re-evaluation of Germany as a post-colonial society is quite a recent development and a quite complex one. In the exhibition, we chose a narrative that exceeds the boundaries of formal colonial expansion in a spatial and temporal perspective. Furthermore, the memory of German colonialism until the present was given reasonable space in the exhibition. And we addressed the persistence of colonial ideology throughout the exhibition, for example, by making racism a subject of discussion and by performing a sensible use of language and images. And next to that introductory panel, we also had a text that actually spoke about the sensible use of language as well in the exhibition. I turn now to the visitor book. Although we don't know much about the background and the motivations of the visitors, the visitor book provides an interesting source insofar as visitor reactions manifest themselves independently of any researcher's agenda, what Sharon MacDonald called a kind of visitor research against the grain. The visitor book was positioned at the exit of the exhibition, and engaging with the book marked a specific moment of closure concerning the visit. And it marked a specific moment when people engage with opinions of other visitors. Only a small fraction of the visitors decided to inscribe themselves. The book comprises around 700 pages with multiple entries, so around 200 visitors share one page. But many visitors were reading in it, what you experienced when you were in the exhibition, and in many entries, people reveal themselves as readers. The visitor book is a space where, by reading and writing, and by agreement, affirmation, and opposition, polarizations are carried out. And this page that I'm showing to you here is just one example of a struggle for the power of opinion. I didn't translate this one, but you can see that there's lots of commenting and affirmation and opposition is going on between these different positions. It's not so often that entries describe the exhibition as informative or formulate a rethinking after visiting. Examples are the exhibition is an eye-opener or colonialism as an awareness gap. Few entries are emotional and concerned especially with violence. Terms that occur are frightening, moving, shameful, merciless, frank, or sobering. Overall, entries hold in many cases very strong opinions, contrary to the assumption that there is little prior knowledge, and with it, not much of a stand towards colonialism in Germany. The exhibition is received less as a historical overview, but rather as a political signal, a signal that polarizes and releases great emotions and effects. Thanks and defense occur frequently, and it is possible to identify parties in this that often use similar terminology. Positive reactions acknowledge and identify with the critical positioning of the exhibition, also with reference to the symbolic power of the exhibition venue, the National Museum. The exhibition is received as a coming to terms with history, and the notion which is central here is overdue. More vocabulary recurrently used for the exhibition is important, a neglected topic, or the exhibition takes a stand, followed by thanks for the engagement. Negative reactions take to the term one-sided again and again, which is, interestingly, always used as a reference to a too critical presentation. And these reactions enter for a more positive image of colonialism. Thus, colonialism here is not presented correctly, not objectively, and in this context, it is constantly referred to the aspects of infrastructure, health, and education for evidence. Other negative reactions judge the exhibition as a moral political exhibition, and this party forms the strongest voice in the visitor book. Questions about guilt and responsibility are sensed and very forcefully rejected. The exhibition is called Political, Tendentious, Ideological or Propaganda, again and again. The term political correctness is employed perpetually, as it is the case in right-wing populist discourses in Germany as a denunciation of current identity politics. These positions, positive and negative, go along with specific attitudes towards temporality. In defensive comments, you'll find the claim to see colonialism as an isolated and finished history, and to understand colonialism in the context of the values of that era. Commonly used wordings are, in retrospect, it is easy to judge through the glasses of today, and the exhibition is declared as Zeitgeist. In the positive comments, links to the presence of the colonial are drawn, for example, everyday racism, right-wing populism, economic power asymmetries of flight and migration, and claims concerning museums and political leaders are asserted. Against this background, the exhibition is repeatedly described as a first step, a good start, and a post-colonial presence is imagined called for. As indicated, a collective memory of German colonialism is inevitably entangled with a formative experience and memory of National Socialism in particular. The DDR plays also a role in the visitor book. And it is interesting to see how the claim for the recognition of the genocide in Namibia is interwoven with it in the sense of a multidirectional memory. National Socialism and the Holocaust are points of references on different levels, but it is hardly touched upon openly. In one example, a visitor notes, the terms genocide and concentration camp refer to crimes of a different nature. So National Socialism is beyond compare here, despite the fact that the term concentration camp was coined in the colonial project in Namibia. There's one pattern of reaction in which colonial injustice is somehow recognized, but not without reference to the wrongdoings of other European colonial powers. And it speaks a lot about the tiredness with and resistance against another chapter of German troubled history. So this is one entry where you can see one of these positions. On the other hand, international entries, which are positive almost without exception, often articulate the desire for a similarly critical exhibition in one's own country. Consequently here, they address the German state in the visitor book, not the museum or the curators, with their entry and congratulate for the critical attitude coming to terms with colonialism. Authorities are negotiated with regard to the topic of the exhibition, and here and there biographical positionings are articulated, like the grandson of a moshi planter or someone who has engaged in anti-racist work in mines, but only occasionally, and Larissa will speak about this later on. In the context of identities, there's an interesting sideshow around a poster. Its purpose in the exhibition is repeatedly questioned and described as being far-fetched or out of place. It is a soap advertisement that shows a white woman in a white dress. So people seem to be definitely over-challenged in terms of critical whiteness. In conclusion, I'd like to turn to the visitor book as a source again, and I'd like to argue that it constitutes to the visitors a counterpart which stands for the museum. In this sense, the visitor book provokes and documents strategies that are employed to evade the expectations that are directed towards museum visitors. Graffiti from school classes are one practice to refuse to this role. Another and very salient distancing strategy is to dodge behind sarcasm and to break taboos. These entries provoke racist images and describe evasion maneuvers. Examples are, I'm going to eat a gypsy schnitzel now. I don't know if that term is familiar. And I take my white man now and go. It is striking that criticism in a post-colonial perspective is hardly represented in the book. I'd never argue that this criticism did not apply to this exhibition. In fact, the Who Speaks would be a legitimate question in view of this exhibition. Rather, I would argue that the invisibility of a post-colonial or black German perspective in the visitor book mirrors the specific institution, the National Museum. A post-colonial perspective might just not feel addressed by this National Museum of History, and lost in critical thought walk by the visitor book. Thank you.